When two guys pull together, it's teamwork. In foul or sunny weather, it's teamwork.
All right. I know you're loving that song by now. Okay, so we are about to start home team session 3. It is our last time together. So we thought, just to start very quickly, what we're going to do is give you a very quick little energizer conversation for the love of all things food while we're eating. And I don't know if your inbox is anything like mine, with emails from my aunt and wondering who's going to bring the green beans on Thanksgiving. So what we want you to do is just share, what is your guilty holiday pleasure food? Okay, so just take a, and you've got 1 minute to do it, so just go around the table. What is your favorite holiday food? Ready, go. So our last session is going to be focused on the action. So we had a chance to talk about what are the traits of good collaborators. We talked this morning about what are the lessons that we've learned about collaboration. And this is our last chance to kind of say, okay, what are the actions? What are the things we're going to do moving forward, and a way for us to make a commitment about that to each other? So the next, there's a series of 6 steps we're going to do, and it's kind of direction heavy. So I need you to just make sure you're with me. I know you're eating and there's a lot going on. I'll explain the activities and we'll get you going here. So what I want you to do first is we're going to give you, while you're finished eating, I know you just are getting started, many of you, you remember at the beginning of the conference, you discussed this question. It was when you met your commitment companion, right? What's one top of mind collaboration or challenge that you are facing? And you discussed, what's the thing that's really gnawing or nagging at you? What we want you to do now is at your entire table discuss, because of what I've learned from the last 2 days, what am I going to do moving forward on that challenge, on the one that I started with in my mind, okay? I'm going to give you about 15 full minutes, so just have a chance to eat your lunch, discuss this question, and then we'll come back, okay? Go ahead.
When
all right.
Two guys pull together, it's team.
Hopefully you had a nice conversation there, and we're going to go right on into our next thing. I hope you're enjoying your beef tenderloin. We're going to give you kind of a multitask thing here, so you have to kind of eat and do at the same time. But what we're going to ask you to do is, if you can turn in your program to page 31, if you have your program with you. If you can turn to page 31, what you'll see there is this box that says, in the new year, I will. And what we want you to do is just scribble down top of mind, what are the things in the new year in terms of collaboration that you want to do differently? That because of what you've learned, because of what you've talked about at this conference, you're going to do differently. And you don't need to just write one, you can write many. So we're going to give you a minute to jot down your I will statement or statements. And when you're finished, you're going to sit next to your commitment companion. Step 2 is you're going to share your I will statement with your companion, and they're going to give you some feedback. So maybe they're going to say, you know, this isn't really clear, you could refine this better. Or, I see that you've got 3 statements here, which one do you prioritize? If you could only do one, which would you do? Okay? So what you're going to do again is, in your book, if there's not enough room, please use the notes. You're going to write your I will statement, you're going to sit next to your companion, you're going to share your statements, and then you're going to give each other feedback. Okay, and I know you're eating, I'm sorry we're cramming so much in. We're gonna give you about 5 minutes to do that. Okay, so go ahead and get started. All right, coming back. All right, so hopefully you had a chance to write down your statement and get some feedback from your peers. We are now moving to step 3. There they are, of 6 steps. So what you're going to do, and please wait until I finish giving the directions to make sure that you're with me. If you could pick a date in January 2016 or even February to connect with your commitment companion. And what we want you to do, if you turn to page 32 in your book, it's got that fun little save the date. Because we're thinking about this I will statement as a bit of a resolution, right? Your collaboration resolution. We want someone to hold you accountable. So if in your book, what you're going to do is you're going to put the date in your book. I also want you to get out your phones right now, get out your calendars, do that annoying thing like, are you available on the 13th from 2 to 4? No, I'm not. Which time zone? Okay? I also want you to remember that no, you cannot schedule something over it at a later date. okay? This is really important, and you're making a commitment to this now, so you keep that on your calendar. And in January, you're going to ask about your commitment companion's progress on their I will statement. So what you need to do in these lovely lines below is write down what they just told you. What are they working on? Because in February, you might not remember from the holiday buzz, and it's been a while, what they said they were working on. So this is your note to yourself, or you can put that in the calendar invite. Okay? So pick a date, get it in your calendar, get it on here, and write down what it is that your partner is dealing with so you can ask them about it. Ready, go. All right. Your jokes. We are almost done. All right, so now you've got a date on your calendar with your buddy. You've made a commitment. Things are going well in the new year. Now what we're going to do, I'm going to explain all these steps in a row, so let me get through them again. We're going to go through steps 4, 5, and 6, okay? Step 4, what you'll see is there's a postcard on your table. What we want you to do is to address it to yourself. You're going to jot down a short version of your I will. Maybe it's a revised one. Maybe it's the prioritized one, the most important one. Write it clearly and simply to yourself. So now you have it in your book. Your partner's going to keep you accountable for it. And you're going to get a postcard that's sent to yourself that says it. Okay? And it also has a space for you to write the date on there as well as a reminder. The fifth step, for those of you that are social media inclined, is to take a photo of it and tweet it. What we're going to try and do is build like a virtual I will wall, right? So what are all of the commitments that are being made at this conference? To think about what is the massive transformation that will come if we stay true to our commitments in this country, which is a pretty cool and powerful thing to think about. So the last step is that before you leave, and we're going to be in here for a while, you can either hand your completed postcard to a GEO staff member if you see one, or you can just drop them, and there's these big white boxes on the way out. Okay? So I'm going to run through those again really quick. Address a postcard to yourself, write your I will statement and your the date and time you're meeting on it. Take a photo and tweet it if you are so inclined, and be sure to drop it in on your way out. Okay? Just give you a couple minutes to do that, and then we're going to come back for our final wrap-up. All right, if you could bring your attention back up here. All right, so we're just about finished, but I was hoping we'd have just a few minutes for any brave soldiers who are willing to share out their I will statement. You know you want to make a big old public statement about what you're going to do. Anybody? Proud of their commitment? Oh, yes, great, thank you, over here, in the center of the room, yeah.
Oh, hi, I'm R.T. Freeman, I'm with the Ontario Trillium Foundation, and my I will statement is, I will listen more, I will listen deeply, and I will listen to understand.
Great, thank you, that's a great one, yes, thank you. Do we have another one? Over here? Great. Yes, thank you.
I'm Jen Bokoff, and I am going to develop a collaboration checklist for myself and my team, and also highlight more stories about collaboration with clear takeaways on GrantCraft.
Wow! A collaboration checklist. That's awesome. Was that talked about in one of the groups, or is that just your idea? That's a great idea. Just things to remember maybe every time you're going to go into a meeting or a collaborative moment. That's a great point. Great idea. Can I get one more? Is there one more I will statement that we can share out? Anyone? Yes, back in the back in the blue sweater. Yeah. What? Hold on, you need a microphone. I want everyone to hear that super well because it was awesome. Will you repeat that, please?
I will repeat that we are the best home team. We're the best home team ambassador. Thank you, Joanne. And that we will have quarterly conference calls with each other to hold each other accountable as a team.
Winning.
Already
winning.
Scheduled. Already scheduled.
That is awesome. Wow. Wow, I feel all good about things. That's great. That's great. All right, I'm so glad you shared that. All right, before we wrap up for our plenary session, just some things to think about upon returning home. You know, the people that you work with know better than you do how well you are at collaborating or not. So ask them when you come home, how am I? What could I work on? Right? They know. And if it's a safe environment, they'll tell you. So that's something you can discuss when you come home. And also, with whom could we partner, right? It's usually the same people that are thinking about partnerships, but there's lots of folks I'm sure that you work with that don't maybe get a chance to voice that and see gaps that you might not see. So with whom might we partner in order to strengthen our work? Okay, so those are just some two questions to leave you with as you are about to head home. And before that, before I close up, I wanted to share this lovely little collaboration video with you. It's real short, so just bear with me. Exactly. So, you know, may the iceberg of your collaborations go well. May you shuffle around at the same time and avoid the killer whales of problems that tend to take us down. Best of luck in the work as you move forward. Thank you so much for spending this time with me over the last 3 days. I've really enjoyed it. Thank you.
Can we have one more big round of applause for Kate? This has been an amazing experience. Thank you, Kate, for facilitating this.